Good morning, everyone. It's a beautiful morning in Sweden. I think this is day 5. I start to lose the count a bit, so I better stop doing that. So it's a little bit above zero. So the ice is melting here and there, but no snow as you can see. And yeah, the weather is a bit up and down. It's a bit unclear. At one weather prediction, it says there will be snow the next days, and next it's one day of fall and then the next day rain. So tomorrow it's going to be a lot of rain. And actually tomorrow I was planning to walk around the lake near the research station. So what we decided to do, that it would be best that I would do that hike today. And then tomorrow, when the weather is bad, yeah, I'm going to stay inside. I'll have so much material and photos and videos to go through. And I might actually be able to produce my first vlog that will probably of my trip getting here and the trip in the hike. You guys already seen that vlog, but yeah, at this moment I still have to produce that vlog. So what the plan is today is to walk around this lake, and there is a lot of different habitats. There is, I think you call it moorland in English, and there is a forest, and there is of course the lake. I have no idea if we will see much wildlife, so I'm not going to do any predictions on that, but we'll see what happens. So just around the corner there, we placed a wildlife camera. It is the mating season of the lynx. And yeah, you might have seen the lynx that we trailed. And we placed a wildlife camera on that trail. Because apparently in this season, the lynx will follow their own trails more in search of mates. It's a special wildlife camera. Usually wildlife cameras at night shoot black and white, right? They use infrared. But this one uses a flash, a white flash. So if an animal will pass over there, it will make photos. I tried the camera at home in the Netherlands already, and there I made this photo of a beach marten. So that's pretty cool, right? That's it's not the quality of a DSLR trap, and the flash is in front of the camera. You don't get creative lighting with a flash on the side. So that, yeah. Wildlife cameras. There are so many of you guys who email me asking, "Hey Jeroen, what should I do with wildlife cameras?" And that's a thing that's so hard, because I do not have the knowledge of all the models that come out each year. So also in the case with this camera, I would just recommend go to the people who really know. If you have a budget and if you have a wish list of what a camera can do, should it do video or should it do photo or both, go to the people with knowledge that can help you further. I can wholeheartedly recommend wildlife monitoring solutions. They helped me with this camera also. Email them with your budget, email them with your wish list, what you expect from the camera. And yeah, Leonard is a great guy. He takes all the time to help you out. So I will put a link down below. Sadly, no photo of a lynx. But I did get a whole bunch of photos from the European hare. And as often is the case, when you find the prey, you will also find the predator. In this case, a red fox who caught a European hare. You see all those spruce cones? And that those shields have been split in the middle? That's a sign of the crossbill. There's a bird which beak has, it crosses its beak and that it uses that to split open those shields so it can take out the seeds behind it. And the crossbill is one of the species that I hope I have some luck in photographing today. Wish me well. If you want to know more about tracking, on my website you can buy my tracks of West European animals. It's also a great way to support the channel. So there's a little peninsula here. That might be a good place. Oh, that's really pretty. But to use my thermal camera and take a look all around the shore to see if there are any animals walking around. Nothing. There's a bit of the problem also here in Sweden. There's so much wildlife. There are tracks and signs of animals everywhere, but especially in winter, Rick also says the difficulty is in seeing them. So let's continue. So I was saying earlier that there would be moorland, but that is of course, that's nonsense. This is not moorland, but more bog, right? Peat bog, that's the correct name. Whiskey producing peat bog. But no whiskey producing over here. But this looks really nice, so I'm gonna take some time to take a look. Maybe scout around with the infrared camera again. There's still only one raven who flew over. That's the only thing. But into the bog. It's those spruce is the correct name, right? Some of those spruce all the way in the top, they have a large collection of cones. That's where those crossbills are feeding. So I'm looking around in all the spruce trees in the tops. And if there's a large collection of those cones, I stick around for a while to see if a crossbill will come. At least one bird. What's the English name, siskin? Yeah. Beautiful bird, beautiful bird. Cross Bill, finally! Oh, I stuck around over here because on this field I have trees all around me and suddenly I could hear them. And one sat on a tree, I think about 100 meters away. Oh, there was really a lot of contrast with the background and the bird. But I think it will be a really nice black and white arty type of photo. So I don't know yet if I can get any color out of it or one of the other photos. But already this photo, I'm really happy with. That's really cool. So I'm just going to stick around for just a bit longer to see what happens over here. But happy, happy, happy. I was able to make one more photo. But although this photo has more color, the composition isn't really doing it for me. But the disappointment of that was soon forgotten, as I would get a great chance to photograph the bullfinch, one of my favorite small songbirds. Bullfinches. We have them in the Netherlands also, but so many, so close. Oh, happy. That's it for me, folks. I'm back on the road. Not as much wildlife as I hoped I would encounter today. Still, I hope you liked this vlog. If you did, as usual, would really help me and the channel if you leave a like and a comment. And then I see you again in my next vlog.